Officers, ladies and gentlemen, in the unlikely event of a fire alarm activation, you will be required to evacuate the building immediately using the nearest designated fire exit clearly indicated throughout the building. Designated staff are on duty to act as fire marshals. Your fire assembly point is situated at the back of the building on exchange flights. May we ask you to kindly switch your mobile phones to silent? Toilets are located on the first floor and throughout the building and are clearly signed. Accessible toilets are located on the ground floor. Thank you.
Thank you. So let's start on the formal business of the meeting. I think at the moment we have two apologies for absence from Councillors Barrington and Doyle. Are there any further apologies, Councillor? We've got the others already submitted, so we have them listed from the bank here. So then, let me turn to the minutes of the last two meetings. If you recall,
more flustered today. I invite all members to declare any disclosable pecuniary or personal prejudicial interest in any item of business at this meeting. There are none.
Thank you. And I will move on to the minutes of two meetings. If you recall, the meetings of the minutes of the meeting on the 19th of July were queried at the last meeting. Those slight amendments have been made to the satisfaction of those who queried it, and therefore I'm moving and wish to sign two meetings held on the 19th of July as amended and the 20th of September. Councillor Bradford.
I think as we tabled in the papers, there's an amendment representing the fact we raised a councillor late called Councillor Gerard Dunn's place for children's voices and for women's voices. I think that's been tabled.
That was covered.
Yeah.
I'm not sure. No, it was agreed, yes.
It has been sticky. So I'll
just sign these. Who's trying to come in and why? Thanks for that. Thank you. You need to turn yours on.
Just on the attorney on page 10, talk about the amendments to that motion. It says first speech by Councillor Mayhew, which is actually my first speech. I think it's how it was in the minutes originally, and the agenda originally for that meeting, but obviously hasn't been changed in the minutes. I actually swapped to my name.
Right, we'll make that alteration. So I understand you will be speaking later to make your thoughts. Okay, right. Someone was. Right, so there's an extra button here tonight. I don't want to practice with it. We then move to item three, announcements.
Yeah, thank you very much, Deputy Lord Mayor. I'll start by thanking you for stepping into the breach and chairing this evening's meeting. I'm sure this will be a good warm fact for the year ahead. First and foremost, I'm not going to say too much on this issue, but I know we'll be debating the Middle East issue later on. I hope I can set the tone for the evening by saying that I hope it's good for everyone in this chamber and across the city that we all want to see a lasting, peaceful solution for the Middle East. Obviously, as well, I'm very conscious now that we've reached a sensible point in our administration at 1/8 of our term of 4 years. And it's been great actually in recent weeks just to look back at some of the successes we've delivered. Things like open southern grasslands, Councillor Robertson, Collins did that first appointment of the neighbourhood managers that will be out in their kind of localities early in the new year, really stepping forward with that neighbourhood model, and delivering £17 million retrofit homes of more than 1,000 vulnerable residents. A lot of things early on in the term will already be delivered. Since we last met as well, it's been great to go through the Eurovision evaluation process, showing how successful Eurovision was for the city. Equally, it's been great to welcome a delegation from Malmo on a couple of occasions to learn from Liverpool's successes as they will host Eurovision next. I think we all know in this city that Liverpool is one of the global capitals of football, and it's absolutely fantastic that Brandymoor Dock will be one of the host venues when the Euro 2028 Football Championships comes to Britain in the next few years. Some of the other things that have happened since the last full council meeting, we've started the process of investigating the insourcing of LSSL, street cleaning, waste collection, building quality, frontline services, and only last night we took the decision to begin the process to insource the statutory services for school for Liverpool. Equally as well, I was very proud to cast the City Council's vote for the command authority in favour of bus franchising, beginning that process of re-regulating our bus network and bringing that back under public control. And again, only this week, we've actually opened a second of five family clubs across the city, a great new facility developing on the great children's centre approach we've already got down in Speak. And equally, on our improvement journey in children's services, it's been great to have our first Ofsted improvement visit, and there's some really good positive progress, a lot more to do, but a good step in the right direction. So, Deputy Lord Mayor, this administration is very much delivering and getting on with the job. So let me make a final point about the government down in Westminster. It gives me no pleasure whatsoever that we've had to write to them on two occasions in the past for myself and Councillor Doyle, writing about the homelessness, the housing crisis that we've got within the city. We are still waiting for a response to that letter. At least Jeremy Hunt has indicated that housing allowances and housing benefits can go up somewhat. But things like Section 21, no fault evictions, still have not been banned. Equally as well, we had to write to myself and Councillor Bennett to the Chancellor this week about the Federation statement. Well, I have to say, it's pretty thin in terms of what the government has served for. Nothing for cities and provinces like our own. I hope I speak for everyone in this chamber when we say we want to get back at this government, and I know I firmly speak for everyone on this side, but we're very positive and confident that will be the Labour government that replaces it, and particularly off the back of the successful Labour Party conference that's been hosted here in Liverpool in the past few weeks, I know this city is in a good and strong position that when we get a change, we can benefit from it. Thank you, Lord Mayor.
Councillor Catchpole, you have a minute to respond.
Thank you, my Lord Mayor. Can I welcome Councillor Robinson's comments and particularly welcome to those, and one of those is seeing the back of this government, and I know your side will look forward to that, but trust me, this side here, I'm sure everyone in this council chamber is there. A second point on bus deregulation and bringing them back into control in this city and in this city region. Completely agree and completely welcome that initiative. And I just want to thank the Democratic Services staff for the way that they've done going into this council meeting, because quite often about words and phrases, but we don't realise how much work these staff actually do. So I'm going to put on there all my thanks to the staff. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Councillor Cashman. We're now going true spirit of Liverpool, working together across faiths, ethnicities, religions, backgrounds to create one Liverpool of which we can be proud. I would simply ask all speakers, either from the public or from this council, to respect that spirit of solidarity today and work together, because we might choose at some stage to niggle about particular parts of the resolutions, but by and large, we can speak as one on what we consider the main issues in the Liverpool state. So with that, having said that, we're now going to take two items which are connected with the Palestine situation, and the first is from Johnson.
Change and the Liverpool citizens' jury. And it states verbatim, Council instructs the Chief Executive and officers to convene a Liverpool citizens' jury of a representative sample of residents to inform recommendations to the Cabinet in relation to net zero ambitions. Right, so there are three, I think, basic questions to be asked. How are they going to be chosen? How many people are going to be chosen? But what's more to the point? What kind of people are going to be chosen? Because if you want to scrutinise policies in relation to net zero, you've got to have people who have the expertise, the knowledge to actually create a dialogue with the council. Or what's going to happen? It'll be a non-response. If it's going to be true, if it's going to be a realistic dialogue, then you can't just have an arbitrary number of people from the city. It's got to be real. Right, in terms of the motion, I agree with two things. I think that the Tories are an absolute disgrace in the way that they've postponed a lot of their climate change policies, an absolute disgrace. And I commend the council for the work they're doing in protecting parks in deeds of dedication. That is a wonderful step forward for the city of Liverpool. But what I have to say is, if you want the people of Liverpool to have confidence in you, then there are certain things that have happened that perhaps have spoiled that. Number one, last year, we had a consultation on how the city was going to be governed. Okay, there were three choices. City mayor came first, a leader, and cabinet came last. Right. Instead of listening to the people of Liverpool, the choice that came third was chosen. I'm sorry, but that is a disgrace. Also, in 2019, right, the city had said that they were going to have a climate change emergency. Excellent, I like it, it's really good. But what happened in the same month? Bixted Gardens was destroyed. One of the most beautiful, I've been in many times, one of the most beautiful places right in the city centre. My friend and I was there after 4 years, it's just an absolute wasteland. So please, if you're going to do the citizens' panel, please do it in the right way and win the citizens of Liverpool over. Can I just finish with this? Because I think it's really important. I'm sorry if I go over this. Right. This is from the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change. And it really got to me, and I think it will be the same with you. I'm just going to say this over. The stark fact is that the planet is facing a catastrophic future. Over the entire industrial era, some 2.3 trillion tonnes of carbon dioxide have been released. governments have this idea that if we can keep to an increase of...
Thank you.
point of view of accuracy, we have Jews, Muslims, Palestinians and Israelis living here on Merseyside. Can anyone identify whether the word Israel is in the mention? Israel is the only democratic nation in the region. That of itself does not mean that it can do no wrong, of course not. But not using the name of a country may delegitimize it and potentially question its right to exist. Incidentally, I can't see the expression innocent Palestinians. I can't see the expression innocent Israelis. The danger of this motion, as far as NDRC is concerned, is the risk of inflaming the conscience, sowing the seeds of division and causing anti-Semitism. We should also have asked for safety term of the hostages. The most important question is there hope for peace between Israel and the people of Gaza and the West Bank? If you want peace, then support those on both sides who want it. With my respectful submission, that is where your energies would be best served. And with some reservations, we welcome Labour's amendment, which supports the intent of communal cohesion.
Respected councillors, our dear friends. As mosques across the Liverpool region and the communities that we serve, we desperately urge all political, faith and civic members to add their voices to the growing chorus of urgent ceasefire in Gaza. We commend the majority of our local MPs who have publicly supported this. They stand on the right side of history. We urge all remaining elected members and leaders across all levels to follow their example by calling for an immediate ceasefire. As our leaders, you should know that the people of our region stand for social justice and the protection of the powerless. The continual bloodshed, the killing of innocent civilians, and the cries of babies, children, women, and the elderly is truly heart-wrenching. As they bleed, our hearts bleed also. Humanitarian causes will not end the violence, only a ceasefire can. Enough is enough. Humanity doesn't have any political allegiances. It's time to put politics aside and stand together as one community of Liverpool. Our common humanity only serves to preserve the life and the dreams of our fellow brothers, sisters, sons and daughters in humanity, irrespective of their backgrounds. We implore the council to approve this motion and in doing so act in the best interest of humanity, which will only serve to strengthen our community bonds in Liverpool and unite us in this difficult moment and not divide us. Cease fire now.
Thank you. I'm not going to ask you to agree the first
because I fear whatever you say or whatever you suggest may be misrepresented or misconceived by someone. That is not the intention. But it also is, I think, one of the most humbling opportunities to show the best of Liverpool. Every political group has gone through a tortuous, and I think that's probably the most polite way of describing the last couple of weeks, a tortuous soul-searching, and come to a consensus where we will respect all the communities, all the bereaved, all the victims of violence, and support a long-term solution. The combined motion will be our give my thanks to my colleagues, Tom Crowe, Alan Gibson, to support the original motion. We've got this into this debate. Without their support, I don't even know what happened. Thank you, Tom. Thank you, Alan. I'd like to thank Liam. I'd like to thank Carl, who actually, not together, and not on controversial changes, but I know will give some of the members a little bit of fear, but we came to a common view for the common good. And what does this motion in the mind say? We absolutely condemn the brutal attack and the brutality of the attack by Hamas, not only just on the Jewish community in Israel, but actually a lot of the overseas workers who were working in Israel. What do we call for? We do want a two-state solution, and we do want a viable Palestinian state, and we do want a long-term solution that will assist all those communities to live and coexist. We can't ignore the long-term injustices. And can I use a phrase that I've used with many friends? Israel has astoundingly won many wars, but what it hasn't won is a peace, a long-term peace. And that may mean, and will mean, looking at providing a viable Palestinian state. That's my personal view, and I'll share that again. And I say that humbly. It has been a painful process. I have to say, as a liberal, I've always been very conscious of the view. I will defend your right to say something I don't like, and I respect my right to disagree with you. I have to say, I have found it quite alarming that the ability for people to say what they think is now being said, you can't say it because it might offend someone. And I have to say, I find that erosion of free speech a very retrograde view. That is not criticising the advice we've got from officers, that is not criticising people's intent, but it is a concern I want to put on the table in public debate. Before today, and before this last fortnight, I thought the unmentionable C word in Liverpool was conservative. Over the last 2 weeks, the unmentionable word was ceasefire. That is in the motion. Welcoming the four-day temporary ceasefire and wanting a permanent ceasefire with a permanent solution. I think that's what we can all agree on. That's what is being moved today. That is what I am heartened and humbled to move to this council. Not everybody will want to be happy with every single sentence, everything he wants. But calming the common good and defining what we believe in is a statement of faith where we can represent all faiths and those of none. We can represent one city and we can show politicians from other cities and other countries what can be done. For all those who protested for a peace process, thank you. For all the faith leaders from all different faiths who called for peace, long-term solution, thank you for your leadership. Good night, and God bless you all.
I understand that this Councillor Crowe will formally second, but then pass his speech over to Councillor Martin Lady, who will be making his maiden speech in this chamber.
Right, sorry.
speaking and making their comments, but it's a formal way of putting this on the agenda properly, as it's very different because it relates to something that we found out about this morning. So can I put it to council, I agree that this becomes a substantive motion.
Okay.
Thank you. Councillor Grant.
Thank you, Lord Mayor. I am delighted to be seconding the amended motion that was brought about through constructive dialogue, through collaboration, to make sure that everybody was happy with the wording and it reflects our desire as a council to make the most positive possible comment on this extremely serious topic. But as you mentioned, I'd like to pass on, I'd like to speak to Councillor Ryan Lady, who'd like to make his first speech.
Thank you, Tom, and thank you, Lord Mayor. I would have preferred my first speech to be on a lighter subject than the conflict in Gaza. But when it comes to situations of this magnitude, if we remain silent, we are complicit. When we see a friend is clearly in the wrong or is going too far, it's our duty to call out that behaviour and do what we can to stop them causing harm to themselves and to others around them. This is the situation we find ourselves in when it comes to the Israel-Gaza conflict. The current conflict has seen a huge rise in incidents of anti-Semitism and Islamophobia across not only Liverpool but the wider country. This is completely unacceptable. I don't know that we all condemn such behaviour. There is absolutely no excuse for the abuse, discrimination and targeting of people in this way. It is imperative that we, as elected representatives, are careful and precise in our language to avoid feeding the fire of racism and discrimination. This is why my criticisms are of Hamas and the Israeli government and not to be applied to any other groups or individuals. I am supporting a motion to call for a ceasefire because as a humanitarian, I am sure to have a loss of life since October 7th. The actions of Hamas are completely reprehensible and in no way can attacks on civilians be justified and the taking of hostages constitutes a war crime. While I understand and support the Israeli government in attempting to rescue the hostages and trying to bring about an end of Hamas, and aim you can all support, the way they've gone about it is disproportionate, counterproductive, and doing to repeat the mistakes of Hamas. The current conflict cannot be resolved by military means. There is no military solution to the problem of Hamas. The only solution to this problem is peaceful. We need to call for an immediate ceasefire and ending the siege of Gaza to allow aid to enter into the injured Palestinians in Tuesday. The humanitarian cause will only provide a brief respite and then killing will continue. We have seen a never-ending peace process up to now that has delivered us death, destruction, pain and loss, with the prospect of a two-state solution looking increasingly distant. This is not a state of affairs any of us should be content with. I know for sure I am not. We need to support both Israelis and Palestinians to bring about peace and meaningful progress towards a two-state solution with respect for international law and following on from UN Resolution 2334. We have a responsibility to inform the government of our view and we owe it to our constituents, as well as our consciences, not to be silent, not to be absent in this debate. A growing number of councils across the country have called for a ceasefire. Over a third of the Senate and the Scottish Parliament are backing such a move. I urge you to vote for the motion and call for an immediate ceasefire to end the suffering and bring about a lasting peace.
Sensitive nature of it, the very complex and historic nature of it. So when we got the very positive development that we heard coming out of that negotiated ceasefire and the commencement of the return of those hostages, negotiated and agreed by the Israeli Parliament and Hamas, that was a really positive step forward, and that's why we were really keen to bring forward an appropriate emergency amendment on this issue. I want to thank all the councillors from across this chamber who've got in touch with me with a variety of different ideas, a variety of different words. I want to thank all the party leaders for coming together to agree with this, and I probably won't say this very often in the next 4 years. I certainly want to thank Carl for the work that we've done over the past day to find the situation that we've got to here. I think the other elements why we wanted to bring this forward is to really strongly reiterate this city's strong commitment to a lasting two-state solution, a safe and stable, secure Israel and a viable Palestinian state. That is the only way, ultimately, we will find a lasting, peaceful solution for the Middle East that is such a touchstone issue for the whole of the globe at the end of the day. But equally as well, and I think this is why the word of the amendment is really important, is on focusing on what it means to the people and communities of Liverpool at the end of the day. We're really proud in this city that we will not stand for any form of hate or discrimination, and we will support all of our different communities, be it Jewish community, be it the Muslim community, be it the Christian community, or any community that has particularly felt the tensions over the past few weeks. And I think that's why it's really important that that's a key part of what we reiterate within this motion. How we make sure that at the end of the day, we all want peace, and we will not let this issue divide our city. So thank you, Deputy Mayor, and thank you everybody for coming together to find this unity we're bringing forward tonight. Thank you.
Thank you, Deputy Mayor. And can I also echo Liam's sentiments, and again, completely and utterly fair to Liam. I know that people have agonised over this, and I know other group leaders and other members of this council have agonised over this situation as well. And in that sense, I want to also thank Max Marcus and Mohammed Islam for coming into the council today to address us, because it must have been a really sensitive and upsetting issue and time for them. So thank you very much for doing that. My Lord Mayor and members of the council, I firstly want to welcome the recently announced ceasefire. It's 4 days, we'd like it to be continuous, but I do welcome that news. In setting out our position in this debate,